Hi everyone and welcome back to the Crafty Yellow Camper. My name's Julia. I should probably tell you that each time because I probably don't say what my name is. Anyway, welcome back. And I'm back again to show you another card made with the Cheerful Daisies stamp set and dies. This was the first one on my wish list when I saw the new annual catalogue. As demonstrators, we get to see the catalogues a little bit early, and I was really pleased that this one was on the pre-order because it was the first one I wanted. Okay, so this is the stamp set. It's got some greetings in there. There's four different greetings, and then you've got the daisy images, and then these are the dies that go with it. They're all in a little bit of a muddle, but if you want to have a look, it's on page 111 of the annual catalogue. Now we're going to use this die today, and I want to show you a way of extending the use of your dies. As I've probably mentioned in previous videos, when I buy something, I like to be able to think of five different ways of using it, because otherwise I sometimes fall in love with a stamp set, I buy it and then I don't use it. And that actually just happened to me when I was clearing out my stamp sets from the retiring annual catalogue. I'm really embarrassed to admit there were two that I hadn't actually ever used. So I'd obviously fallen in love with them and then maybe gone off the boil a little bit with them. And they'd maybe been on my desk and I thought, oh, I don't really know what to do with that. Anyway, there are so many beautiful stamp sets. So now I always make sure that I can think of five different ways of using them. And this particular stamp set really spoke to me because of this die. So you will find two other videos on my YouTube channel that use this set, and this is the third one that we did in a class. So let's get started. I'm going to change this up a little bit. This was my original sample, and for my ladies that attend my in-person classes, I changed it up a little bit and added a layer in. So that's what we're going to do today. So I'm just going to tip these bits out. So what we're going to do, I'm starting with some very vanilla. I usually use basic white or basic white thick for my card bases if I'm not using a colour. But then I realised I really like very vanilla. I think it's quite classy and I hadn't used it for quite some time. And I'm going to be honest here, I was running out of basic white thick and hadn't put my order in when I needed to make these cards. So I thought, why not? Let's use up some of the two packs of very vanilla I had lurking in the bottom drawer of my filing cabinet. So very vanilla it is, and very vanilla is very lovely. Okay, so our base is half of an A4 sheet cut lengthways. So if you're in the UK, it's the whole length of the A4 sheet cut at 10.5 because the sheets are 21 centimeters wide. If you're in the United States or anywhere else that uses a different size, this is basically half of whatever your sheet is cut lengthways. I think in America they call it letter size, and I'm not sure if Australia gets A4 or whether they get letter size as well. Perhaps somebody could comment and let me know for future videos. And then what I've done is I've cut a matte layer. So this matte layer is basically half a centimetre smaller all the way around. So this is cut at 10 by 14.3 because folding this in half gives us a card base that is 10.5 by 14.8 centimetres. Okay, so we're going to work on this piece. Now, what I'm going to use is a die cut. So you're probably sitting there watching this thinking, oh yeah, that's really pretty, but that looks like that's going to be a really boring card. It isn't. So what we're going to do, well, I don't think it is. Hopefully you won't think it is either. So what we're going to do, we're going to use this as a stencil now or a mask. So I love to use stencils for backgrounds and I love to use masks. And I think that Stampin' Up! Lately, in a lot of their sets, have been very good to us and given us dies that can be used to make our own masks, which is always good. So I've just basically cut this out of a piece of scrap white. It isn't even Stamping Up white because I didn't want to waste my good stuff. So it's just a piece of white that I had knocking about. And then what we're going to do, we're going to use a blending brush. So I'm just going to reach over and grab a blending brush. Now I'm going for one of my big brushes. Stampin' Up! Now sell them in big and small. I don't actually have Stampin' Up! Small ones, because I already had a whole set of small ones before Stampin' Up! Bought them out, and obviously there's nothing wrong with them, so I haven't replaced them. But I love, 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 love these big ones. Okay, and we're going to bring in some Bubble Bath, which is one of our new colours. It's not an in colour, it's new to our colour families. But it's a really nice sort of pinky purpley colour. And what we're going to do is I'm just going to ink up. Actually, I'm going to put a piece of scrap paper underneath this because I know how messy I am. Please excuse the piece of scrap paper. I was using it earlier. today, this morning, I've been online with demonstrators from all around the world for a demonstrator-only event called Creativity Now. And we have had the pleasure of watching some lovely demonstrations, some sneak peeks, and we got to craft along. I'll show you the cards I made at the end. Okay, so yeah, you've got a little bit of a sneak peek of what I used on my piece of scrap paper. Okay, so I've inked up my brush, and then always make sure you support the head of your brush. The necks of these brushes are very thin. They're thin because they're flexible, so that the brush can get in nooks and crannies, but you do need to support the brush, otherwise you run the risk of snapping them. Okay, and all I'm gonna do is hold it in position. Now, if you feel happier using some repositionable tape or masking tape, then please do that. But for the purposes of this video, I'm just holding it down. I must ask you to excuse my really scrappy nails as well. I've been gardening and I've broken them, and I'm not really very good after having a manicure. I'm not really a girly girl when it comes to that. I like to garden in bare hands and get into the soil, and I volunteer at a community garden, so yeah, got a bit grubby and ruined my nail polish, so it needs to come off. But I thought it was more important to get some videos on my YouTube channel for these cards. So, right, so I'm just very gently going around with my brush and using this die cut that was white and is now not, as a stencil. Okay. And if it moves, you'll be able to see where it was, so you'll be able to line it back up. So if I lift it up, we can see where I haven't been with the ink, and that's where my big fat thumb was. So we've got to go over here. Okay. As I said, if you just hold on to one corner and lift it up, you'll be able to see if you've got it all. We're almost there. And the reason I haven't stuck this down is because I'm going to move it in a minute. But it, as I said before, if you do feel more comfortable sticking it down, do that. So there you go. So that's our first section done. Then we're going to turn it up the other way. I'm terribly inky. And we're going to do exactly the same thing again on the bottom or the top, whichever you like to say. Just make sure you go over all of the sections that have bits cut out. You know, when I did this with nobody watching, I did it really quickly and really easily, and because I'm filming and I know you guys are watching, I'm making a right pig's ear of it. Okay. Okay. Just finish this section off over here, you get the gist. Okay, now I've gone off the bottom of the page on this one. I didn't actually mean to do that. It's meant to be a little bit higher up, but you know, it's no biggie. There we go. So, and then what I'm going to do is just take my blending brush and just go around the edges and give it a little bit more welly this time, just to darken off the corners. And then fill in the gaps in between the two stencils and fill in the gap in the middle. It doesn't really matter if you go a little bit over your design, because yeah, You can always put the stencil back over and make it a bit darker. So on this bit here, I feel like I've really almost obliterated the top of that. So by putting it back over, we can sort of put it back in a little bit. Anyway, we can cover up that with our greeting. The upside of this as well, if you use basic white or basic white thick, you've actually then got some really nicely inked flowers to use in another card. So I'm going to get rid of that. What we're going to do now is stick that onto our card front. And I raised it. Pardon me, raised it up a little bit. I'm just going to put some dimensionals on the back. Now you can see I've run out of actual dimensionals on this sheet, so I'm going to bring in my Teflon coated scissors. I would advise you strongly not to use your snips to cut anything that's got adhesive on it, because what will happen is that eventually the blades will get gummed up. It might take quite a long time. I actually cut some tape before we had the sticky strips available for making shaker cards. I actually cut some tape with one of mine, and I had to actually get my husband, who's a jeweler by trade, to heat them up with his blowtorch in order to get them apart, because they ended up with so much sticky residue. And at that point, I swore that I would never, ever use my snips again for cutting sticky stuff. So we don't actually sell these, unfortunately, but most craft stores have them. But they're coated with Teflon, so you might get a little bit of residue. You can see on there, there's a little bit of a build-up, but you can clean that off with some rubbing alcohol. You can clean your snips with rubbing alcohol as well, but I tend to find that you still get more of a build-up on normal snips. Okay, so what we're going to do then, I've then used the label die from the Cheerful Daisy dies, and I've just put wishing you the brightest birthday, and then that is going to go across on some more dimensionals. And you can see how great the edges are for doing this kind of thing. They're just the perfect size. Starting to flag a bit now. This is my third video this afternoon. I'm starting to flag. Okay, I should put that up there. Yeah, we'll go there, I think. Okay, so that's our greeting. And then you can see on my original here, I've just cut one of these little fronds from some copper clay. These small dies are absolutely brilliant ways of using up your scraps. So I'm just going to grab a scrap of copper clay. And quickly run another one of those through my die cutting machine. I thought I'd got one in the pot of odds and ends. Whenever I cut things, I tend to cut extras in case I lose one or I mess something up. And I thought I'd got an extra one of these, but it would appear I didn't. Either that or when I knocked the pot off my desk a couple of days ago, it's gone all about. Okay. Where'd it go? Oh, it's still in there. That's fine. Okay. So I'm just going to use my pokey tool. Put my glasses back on, always helps. Just going to use my pokey tool to get that out of the die. This is one of those dies that sometimes you cut it, and particularly if you're using a light colour, you pick it up and think, where's the die cut gone? And it's still in the die. Okay, you have to be a bit gentle pulling it out because you don't want to rip it. Okay, pokey tool out of the way. And then what we're going to do is just add that by tucking that behind the greeting. Going to put the tiniest piece of liquid glue. What I should have done is stuck it to the back of the dimensional. That would have been the sensible thing to do before I stuck the actual label on the greeting. This is a classic case of do as I say, not as I do. So if you have got something really thin like this, you can stick it to the back of the dimensional before you put your greeting on, but I forgot, so I'm just going to have to use some glue And I'm just going to tuck that in like that. And I don't actually want to glue the rest of it down, but what I would like to do is have another one coming out of the bottom here, but I didn't grab a big enough scrap, so I'll do that later. So there's our finished card. Opens out as a tent card to stand up like that. And I hope you'll see that that's another way that you can get some extended use out of your dies. Really quick and simple card to do, but hopefully you'll agree it's quite effective. And I'm just gonna, I can't make a card without Winker Stella. It's just not my thing. I'm just gonna add a little bit of Winker Stella to the middles of the flowers. If you've got the gems that go with this suite, you could add those, but I don't have them. There we go. Right, that's all winked up. Just to give it a little bit of subtle shimmer. Hopefully you can catch that on there. There you go. Right, hope you like the card. Thanks for joining me and hopefully putting up with my waffle. And I'll see you again soon. Thanks for watching. Happy stamping.